Hello students, in the previous class we have observed the column chromatography. Today let us discuss about thin layer chromatography. So as the name indicates, thin layer chromatography is nothing but what? Here whatever adsorbent we are going to take, that should be very thin. Okay, so coming to here, this thin layer chromatography was introduced by a scientist, Ismailov and Schreiber, in 1938. So they have introduced this chromatographic technique under 1938 by the scientist Ismailov and Schreiber. Okay, but here afterwards, but what happened? They bought an analytical technique. But coming to here, E. Sathal, Easthal, in 1958, he was bought a development of this thin layer chromatography. He has developed thin layer chromatography. He also successfully demonstrated the potential usefulness of TLC for a fractionless wide of substances also. So these two are the scientists. Generally, they bought this theory, but Easthal has developed this theory in 1938 by using thin layer plates. So this TLC is also known as several names, that it is having trade names like TLC is also known as what we can say here. Open column chromatography and spread layer chromatography. TLC is also known as open column chromatography and spread layer chromatography. So then what is TLC here? We are saying TLC. So what do you mean by TLC? The mixture of components. It is a separation technique in which the mixture of components are separated by individual components through a thin glass plate. We call it as what here? Thin layer chromatography. So what we can say, whatever components we are separating to individual components, that should be on the thin glass plate, then only we call it as a thin layer chromatography. That's why I have told it is a open column also, and also spread layer chromatography also. So let us discuss here principle. So as we have discussed in the column chromatography, the principle depends upon the adsorption. In the same way here, the thin layer chromatography also depends upon the adsorption. The main principle, it is going to depend upon what here? Adsorption. So here what will be the stationary phase? The stationary phase will be the thin glass plate with silica gel, with silica powder or alumina. Okay, so in a thin glass plate, so let us take this is a thin glass plate. So to this thin glass plate we are adding some silica powder. So means what? To the glass plate, the silica powder is going to adsorb on the surface of the glass plate. Okay, so for example, let us take here, this is a book. The book is a surface and I'm writing with pen now. So means what? These words are going to adsorb on the paper. In the same way here, the stationary phase consists of thin glass plate with silica powder. And coming to here, mobile phase, as we know, we are going to use a solvent, that is a liquid we are going to use. So this is nothing but stationary phase and mobile phase. So then what happens here in this? Generally, the stationary phase, how it is packed with column, here TLC is also coated with glass plate as a uniform thin layer, we are saying. Okay, so the coated plate, the whatever the coated plate is there, this one we call it as chromatographic plate this one we call it as what here, chromatographically, that's why we call it as what here, open column. And coming to mobile phase, what we are doing, in a separate beaker we are going to prepare a solvent. Whenever you are preparing solvent, this one with the sampled one we are going to insert into the mobile phase beaker. Okay, so here this mobile phase will carry only ascending technique only. So we are going to say what here, it undergoes only ascending technique. So means what here, it will flow upward direction, it will not flow to the descending technique, it will not move to the downward direction. If it move to the downward direction, the spots will be not become the, of course it will show the colored spots, but coming to here, what happens here, it is decreasing the gravity. Means what here, it is decreasing the flow of the liquid. When you move to the ascending technique, so the ascending technique will move upward, no, then it can easily flow, then the mobile phase can easily travel, so the force will be more here. So that is the principle of the thin layer chromatography. It will undergo only ascending technique through capillary action only. By placing the spots on the capillary action, we can easily get this one. Okay, so coming to here, advantages. Let us see what is an advantage of the TLC. So the advantages is nothing but it is a simple processor in solid, liquid and also in liquid-liquid systems. So what we can say here, TLC involves simple processor. Simple processor in solid, liquid and liquid-liquid systems. Next one also here, TLC is performed in an analytical as well as also preparative scale. Analytical means that iterations, whatever we are doing, that one quantitative, we can say what we can say, it is a quantitative analysis also we can say. And also TLC can be applied to the entire spectrum of the compounds. It will give spectrum of compounds, and due to its rapid speed, means what here, what we can say, speed, we are going to have the speed of, whenever it is going upward direction, then what happens, there will be flow of the liquid will be somewhat speed. So what happens here, what is the advantage of moving upward direction here, so whenever it is going, we can check the chemical reactions. Okay, due to its rapid speed, we have to check the here, what here, chemical reactions in laboratory and also in industrial process control also we can see. Okay, and also it can be used for food alteration. Food alteration is nothing but what here, is nothing but in, if you see in shops, the food will be storing long time. Okay, if you take pickles or some snack items, whatever you take there in shops, what happens, they will store for very long time. At that time, what will happen, they are using some of the chemicals to store the chemicals. We are using here TLC. Okay, to preserve the food materials, we are using here TLC. And also when the food and drugs are decomposed, okay, when you not store correct in a way, so we can use a TLC. Okay, so if the food is spoiled and drugs are also spoiled, if you are not storing properly, so at the time what we can do, we can, if we can apply here TLC, means it can easily prevent the food. And also it is used for chemical taxonomy. Chemical taxonomy is nothing but what here, when the chemicals are turning into poisonous nature, at that time, if you use TLC, it is very useful for the drugs of the chemicals. Okay, so these are the advantages of the TLC. Now let us see here procedure of the TLC. Let us discuss experimental procedure. So the first step what we have to do is preparation of slurry of the adsorbent. So this is the first step we have to do. So means what here? You have to take a 100 ml of chloroform in a bottle and you have to have airtight stopper. Now what you have to do in that, you have to add 30 grams of silica gel, a small installment with continuous shaking. Then the bottle is tightly stoppered, means continuously you have to shake that one. Okay, to prepare this slurry of alumina or cellulose, you have to add 25 to 30 grams of alumina and rectified spirit or acetone. Okay, so first what here we are preparing slurry, no? So first what we have to take 100 ml of chloroform. For this chloroform you have to add how much grams? 30 grams of silica gel. Okay, so this chloroform is added to silica gel in a continuous motion with a airtight bottle. In an airtight bottle, you have to, with a continuous stirring, you have to keep ready. Okay, we are preparing for slurry. So next, what we have to take? So first of all, we are preparing this slurry, which is known as adsorbent. That indicates what here? Stationary phase. Now, what is the second step we have to do here? The second step is nothing but here, preparation of chromatographic plate or thin layer plate. Preparation of chromatographic plate or thin layer plate. So second step, what we have to do, we have to prepare chromatographic plate or thin layer plate. So in this, what we have to do, first of all, you have to take a clean surface of glass plate. So this is the plate you have to take. Okay, so this plate, what happens, this plate is very clean, it should be very clean. Then what you'll do means you'll spread the here slurry. After taking the chromatography, after taking the plate, what you will do? You will have prepared in the first step, what you have prepared? Slurry. Okay. It is, the slurry is going to adsorb on the plate. Okay. So, the we are keeping this slurry. So, this is the plate. And this is the slurry, which is going to adsorb on the surface. Means we have prepared a stationary phase here. Okay, so then what happens, we are, before placing this slurry, what we have to do, we have to shake this slurry bottle with a continuous motion and you have to remove the stopper. And here two glass plates or slides we are having with a pair of tong. Okay, with a tong what we have to do, so you have to keep it in slant position. And with a tong, you know, in the laboratory we are going to have for holding the glass tubes, everything. Okay, so with the tong, what you have to do, that glass plate is dipped in the slurry bottle. After, it should be uniformly spread out here. Okay, so after uniformly spreading out, each plate, one side of plate and other side of plate also, you have to dip it. So you have to continuously dip. Why? Because if you remove slides quickly, then automatically the liquid, the slurry, whatever you have kept here, it is going to not pass on the edges. Okay, then you have to do carefully. After taking from this, you have to dry this one. Okay, so what we have to do here, after taking the this plate from this slurry, you have to dry this one. The dried one, whatever we are taking here, that should be completely dry. Then this is the preparation of chromatographic plate. Now next one, what we have to do here, spotting of chromatographic plate. Okay, So we have prepared stationary phase. Spotting of chromatographic plate means what? Here we are inserting the mixture of components, right? So here if you are taking, it is a slurry plate which is a stationary phase. So with a capillary tube, what you have to do, you have to, first of all, you have to draw the two lines and you have to place a sample. Okay, so means what? Here in a dilute solution of the given mixture, means the sample whatever you are taking, the mixture of components you are taking here, the mixture of components is placed in this slurry plate, thin layer plate. Okay, so after, with a capillary tube, the capillary tube is very thin, no, like this. With this capillary tube you are spotting this one. So after spotting this one, what you have to do here, the spots should be dry here. Okay, with wet plate we should not keep. Why? Because if you keep it in the solvent, what happens, the solvent will flow, it all will become soluble. So because of this solubility, we can't easily find the separation of the components. So because of that reason only, what we have to do, after filling of slurry, we have, with a capillary action, we have to keep the spots of the mixture of components, we have to spot here. Okay, then we have to dry this one. This is the third process we are going to do. And coming to next one, development of the chromatogram. What is the next process we have to do? Development of the chromatogram. So means what we have to do, we have arranged a mobile phase, right? The mobile phase consists of here, this is a mobile phase we are having, which is containing benzene plus 10% acetone. Okay, we are keeping this one, which is lined inside a jar, right? So now what you have to do means, you have to place this slide over here. First of all, in a beaker, what you have to take, benzene plus 10% acetone you are going to take at its lower end, and you have to place the jar. How you will place the jar here? With a slant position. Okay, so with a slant position you are going to place the jar here, and upwards you are covering with a lid. This is the lid. With a slant position you are placing thin layer chromatography, thin plate you are placing here, which is containing what? Here sample. How you have to place the samples? Whatever you are taking, it should not touch the mobile phase. Then after 5 minutes, what happens? After 5 minutes, it will start flow towards upward direction, like this, the upward direction. Until the mobile phase travels here, the spots will travel. So it may come for here, here, the spot may travel like this. Okay, so this is the development of the chromatogram, which is undergoing ascending technique, upward direction. So next, what you have to do, you have to take out this sample plate and you have to dry it. You have to take out this sample plate and you have to dry it. This sample plate is, the spots is separated individually. Then what you have to do, you have to dry it. So after drying, what you have to do, you have to see the spots. So to see the spots, we have to visual of the chromatogram. So then what you have to do, again you have to keep it in the, this dried spots in the iodine chamber. If spots are colored, okay. If the spots are not colored, then what you have to do here, you have to take iodine crystals in one beaker. Okay, you have to insert this plate which is individually separated. Clear? So the development of this plate, this is the initial spot we are going to take, the first spot, and here we are having solvent front up to where the mobile face is traveled. So, and you have to cover with the lid. So, this is nothing but a development of this spot. So, after iodine passes through this spot, we can easily see the color with a brown, yellow like that. So, this is nothing but general procedure of the TLC. Okay. So, after seeing this, what we can find easily? RF value. We can easily find the initial spot to the solvent front and also the distance we can see. So, these are nothing but what here? These are nothing but applications of TLC. Now, let us see here. Applications of TLC. So, what are the applications? So, the applications of TLC is nothing but here. It is used as a identification. The first application is, it is used as identification. Purification of organic compounds, to identify the organic compounds and also to purify the organic compounds, we can use this technique. And also here, if you take amino acids, proteins, peptides, they are easily separated from urine using silica gel plates. Okay, so what we can say here, amino acids are easily separated from urine. Urine is a peptide. Okay, so amino acids are easily separated. Not only amino acids, proteins also you can take, peptides also you can take. They are usually separated from urine using what here, silica gel. And also it is applied for separation of alcohols, glycols by using alumina. Okay, and also vitamins, antibiotics, food products is separated using TLC. Vitamins, antibiotics, and food products using TLC we can easily separate. Okay, and also fruits for amino acids, milk for amino acids, wine for glucose and sorbitol, meat for carboxylic acid, beer for aromatic acids, orange juice for amino acids. So these are the things we can use for separating amino acids. In organic chemistry, it is used for purity of compounds and various reactions and the progress also we can easily determine of these compounds by using alkaloids, amino acids, antibiotics. So these are the applications of the TLC. And coming to here, we are using different types of adsorbents, right? So we are going to use what here, different types of adsorbent here. A silica gel is a mostly used adsorbent. Why? Because it is acidic, which can easily remove H+ ions. Okay, so here the plaster of Paris is also use it to hold this adsorbent on the plate. And if you take alumina is a basic. Okay, so it is without plaster of Paris. So for the silica gel, why we are using plaster of Paris? Because here to the plate, the silica gel should stick tightly. Because of that only we are using plaster of Paris. For alumina base, no need that one. It can tightly stick. Okay, and also kieselguhr is a one of the element which is a natural adsorbent, we can say here. It is a weak adsorbent compared to silica and alumina. Okay, it can be added to silica gel to give a mixed adsorbent also, or we can add to alumina also. Okay, and also we can use ion exchange cellulose powders. We can use ion exchange cellulose powders like amino ethyl cellulose, diethyl amino ethyl cellulose, carboxymethyl cellulose. So these are the cellulose we can use without adding the plaster of Paris. Okay. So to support the thin layer only, for stationary phase only, we are going to use this type of the adsorbents for TLC. And coming to, as we know, solvents, the mobile phase we are going to use here is petroleum ether, benzene, acetone, CCl4, CHCl3, alcohol. So these are the things we are going to use. Cyclohexane. So these are the solvents we are going to use for TLC. This is nothing but TLC. In the next class, we can discuss the HPLC. Thank you.